And the 2019 edition of the Ladies in Sports Conference, which is a gathering of women in the sports industry, was organized sometime in June. And we had interesting speakers like Women's Tennis Association President Miki Lela. There's also the Nigerian Football Federation first vice president Sheyi Akinwumi, and the former South African women's national team player Amanda Dlamini. And we look forward to the corporate edition, which is set for the 19th of November. And I've still got Tega here, who is the brain behind this fantastic program for women. But then let's see how, let's see a bit of the conference, and when we return, we'll be asking Tega a few questions concerning ladies in sports.
In most parts of the world, sports is largely seen as a male-dominated field. With the recent successes of the FIBA and FIFA Women World Cup, there has been a rise in the number of women eager to take on more sporting roles and getting deeply involved in sporting activities. At the Ladies in Sports Conference 2019, this year's theme, Keeping the Barriers Down, was flooded with notable guests and speakers who were keen to tackle topical issues. The third edition of Ladies in Sports kicked off with the keynote speaker, the Vice President of the NFF, Barrister Sheyi Akinwumi, charging female athletes to endeavor to marry sports with education.
Girls who play sports do better in school. Why? Now, research shows that girls who play sports across the world, it will be shown, are more likely to graduate. Because exercise improves your concentration.
Desire Opara-Nozier, captain of the Super Falcons, stressed the importance of encouraging young ladies who have interest in sports.
The key thing is to, you know, to reach out to them, you know, get to them, come down to their level and you know, encourage them in any little way you can, considering where, you know, what I've faced growing up and rising up to this profession and all that. It wasn't easy, so I didn't want them to, because then I didn't have lots of encouragement from anybody, and I felt I can actually do better. I didn't want to see talent waste and all of that, so I want to reach out to them and let them and encourage them to be whatever they want to be.
Bayana ex-international Amanda Dlamini talked about the importance of female representation, organizing more conferences to support the ladies.
It's absolutely amazing. I think for me, this is my first time coming to Nigeria, apart from wearing a green shirt and going to a pitch. And I'm really excited to be involved and being invited to have such meaningful conversations around women in sports. And hopefully such conferences can actually grow, and not only in Nigeria, but also for the rest of the continent. As a former player, I've realized that there's a lot of people having conversations about women in sports. It's just that I feel as players, maybe they're not aware of the kind of contribution that other women have for them. The representation that there is for all the other women in sports is there. It's just a mere fact of, I feel, the representation coming together with the athletes.
Other speakers, such as top FIFA referee Mercy Tagu from Ghana, the Tigress player Nkechi Akashili, among others, also shared their thoughts.
If you are doing male and female football, I think the male must pull along the women, because when you go to Europe, we have Arsenal's ladies, we have Barcelona ladies, Real Madrid ladies, and they are doing very well. That has informed their national teams, the performance that they put up out there.
I love what they're doing. I wish I can do more of what they're doing. I wish I can join them, like, assist them, be part of them, because this is my dream. This is what I really want to do. And this is what they are doing, like giving back. There's nothing like giving back. There's nothing like giving back. That is your greatest gift than people giving you money.
At the end of the conference, the overall narrative is that sportswomen can keep breaking the barriers when they show up prepared for the roles they desire. Udoka Njoku for PLUS TV Africa.